Yeah, 76.
Okay.
Yeah, back in 76. Back in 69 was a good year.
So let me just get this shit. Right, you guys got comfortable over there with that pillow and everything?
Yeah, I'm chilling.
No, but wait, what is it that you do? You say you like to bring fun to the hip hop.
I produce. Okay. Do it all.
So y'all just do it all.
We try
so
to.
So if we come to y'all, you're going to have a song ready for us to beat.
All that.
Produce. You're going to sing. He's going to be.
How about homie with the camera? Rapping camel? In the
background. You know, I'm the CEO of the situation. You know, I just make sure everything work out right. We doing everything we supposed to do. Keep everything structured.
Management.
You know what I'm saying? Management.
Yes.
You know, whatever you want to call it. I also rap and sing. I don't sing, sorry.
Ooh, rap. People lying. People just saying whatever.
Rapping right, you know. So I just try to make our situation make sense. That's what I do.
Do you got any shows coming up? Like, what is it that you got going on?
Yeah, we're going to Virginia Beach next week.
Okay.
We got a show out there. Also, we got a possible situation to go to London, you know, and do a show with Levi Little, formerly known from Black Street. So we're trying to get on that situation. It's a promo tour. We ain't getting no crazy dollars yet, but you know, we grinding. You
making noise.
Yeah, making noise.
Hey, hey, well, hey, Big House, man, I hear you had the joint, man, at the Mesa Noise. Coco recognized you. Tell us how that situation happened, man.
Oh, the letters to my homies?
Yeah.
I never was a big Twitter head ever.
Right.
So, like, one day I just woke up, thanks to this guy right here.
Uh-huh.
And I was just like, yo, let me get on Twitter and just push this video.
Right, right.
And I just sent it to, like, every DJ that I was following. And that's basically all I was following was
as
DJ.
As you should.
And then I actually went to church that day. That was, like, my first time going to church in a while.
Uh-huh.
And I just went to church, and halfway through church, my phone goes off, and it's like Coco Chanel talking about, you are the featured artist on my website. And I'm like, oh, that's crazy. From 98.7 Kiss.
Oh.
Well, formerly 98.7 Kiss.
Actually used to be on Hot 97. She had a show with Jazzy Joyce and Angie, Ladies Night.
Ladies Night.
On,
Fridays.
Night. Yeah, word. So, you know, she showed us love. And, you know, that's where everything kind of started, a little snowball effect from that recognition. We did a show with DJ Absolute, which got us a Warner Brothers meet. And,
nice.
You know, here we are here today, still grinding.
So you trying to sign to a label or you just want to be independent?
Honestly, right now we want to stay independent and build our buzz as big as we can. Like, I want money. I don't give a damn. I know what I'm worth.
For sure.
Right, okay.
I want my goddamn money.
I hear that shit.
So I hear y'all did a show. It was a little contest, man.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you tell the people about it, dog.
The Absolute joint, man. I mean, yeah, we went there. Fat Boy's joint would kill them. That always kills them. When that Fat Boy joint come on, my big ass start dancing. Everybody start
so
going
you're a
crazy.
Dancer also.
I told you everything. You thought so I was playing.
You were dancing all over there.
You thought I was playing, man. Oh, this is real. Extraordinaire.
Make
literally.
Noise.
All right. So you guys have girlfriends? What's up with that? How was love life? Because we talk about a whole lot of stuff up here. And y'all not in the hot seat because it's three of y'all? Because normally it'd be one.
I got some questions.
Yeah.
I'm single as I want to be.
Let's get
to okay. it. Okay. When it's convenient?
No, I'm single all the time.
I got some questions.
Oh, shit.
What about the rest of you guys? How's that going? Y'all have a little fame? Y'all have a little fame? How is that? How are the ladies treating you guys?
I have a lady.
Aww.
And say it with your chest, though.
Shout out. If she's here with your chest,
say it with your chest.
Shout out to you, baby.
Oh, see. You could be five people. See, you know what? Anyway,
don't do
ladies,
that.
Ladies, y'all can at me on Twitter at Sharon Jeremy.
Okay.
That's how I feel about that.
Okay.
Hey, booze.
So, can I ask you guys a question? What are some reasons to cut somebody off besides cheating?
There's a bunch
lying,
of reasons.
Period.
Nice.
Lying straight up and down.
Life?
Lying.
Lying, okay.
We all lie. Let's get over that.
Yeah. I think. I agree with you.
Getting caught.
Look. No.
We all lie. We all get caught. Let's get over that. Me?
We don't all lie.
Okay, maybe not you. Okay. But everybody else in the world lies.
Yeah.
But to me, a no-go is like really somebody that's not trying to progress. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you're not trying to progress, I can't do nothing with you, you know what I'm saying? If you trying to progress, I don't care if you, you know, just in school, ain't working, ain't got a dime to your name, but if you got a plan, you trying to progress, I can work with that. That's me, you know what I'm saying?
That was a good answer.
Good answer, though.
Good answer. Let's see if that's on the board.
No, it's not on the board.
Nah, I mean, I think the worst thing in a relationship that you could get cut off for is basically being untrustworthy. That don't really, not as far as the lie prospect goes, but like, I hate chicks that like want to check your phone and go on Twitter and all that other stuff. That's kind of crazy to me. Like, you should just trust me to know that I'm not gonna do that,
right?
Or, you know, do you like that? So,
and also it's just
and also
it's like the respect,
right?
It's like, it's my shit. If you don't trust me,
word,
whatever the case is, it's about respect. Because people could be cheating. I think everyone cheats once in a while. Y'all all have cheated. I'm pretty sure we've all cheated before.
Maybe. I never cheated.
Whatever. You cheated. My thing is, like, especially for men, you guys got to, like, keep the respect. Like, make sure she doesn't find out about it. Like, and then, you know, everyone makes mistakes.
Everyone definitely makes mistakes. I mean, it's on you to, you know, better it. Yeah, right.
Don't put it in her face. Don't be on Twitter like, what's up, ma? What's good? DM me. Don't.
Word.
In her face. You know she's going to read it.
You don't got to add that so everybody can see it. You know what I'm saying?
Just DM that shit. DM that shit. What's up with y'all?
And then Twitter is serious.
Keep my mouth shut.
Twitter is serious. Respect her on Twitter. Respect yourself on Twitter. And everything else will be good. You gotta respect yourself. And in that case, you'll respect.
What about you, Sasha?
What?
What about you, Sasha?
What about what?
Yeah, Sasha over there pleading the fifth.
Especially
when we talked about DMs.
You need the question again?
DM that shit.
What are some reasons to cut somebody off besides cheating?
Man, listen, y'all got to get along. If y'all can't get along, that shit ain't going to work. Because the way I look at it is this. You guys are one. When you're in a relationship, you're one. So y'all got to make each other better. If y'all gonna sit there and beef, it's only gonna harm you because you're in a relationship with me. So it's like a cycle, you know what I mean? Like, if you make my day hard, how do you think your fucking day is gonna be? You know what I mean? I'm gonna make your day hard. We won. So that's just the way I see it.
I have another question.
And that's the way people should treat it. Like, what's good for one is good
for
the
other. I have a question,
too. You know? But there's certain things.
Oh, we all have questions.
It gets complicated.
We all have a damn question for you, Sasha.
Well.
It gets complicated.
Can I ask you ladies a quick question?
Wait a minute.
Crazy over here.
I think y'all all forgot about me. Like, come on.
Sorry. What did you want to say?
Go in.
All right, now. Communication is key. So without communication, I'm sorry, but you got to go. You know what I mean? If you are not able to speak to me without the ego, without the bullshit, put all that aside and speak to me with your fucking heart, which I'm gonna give you my heart, then me and you should not even see each other. Like, communication is key. You're not about to hold back on me. You know what I mean? Like,
I went to college for communications, by the way.
That's not acceptable. Also, you know, if you're not doing anything with your life, if you're not, no progress is being showed, no goals, no nothing on the table, like, you're just living in the moment, like, come on, man.
So can I ask my question?
Yeah, go ahead.
So just going off of what Sasha basically said, so now let's just say
I think I'm in the hot seat.
There was no trust.
You're
right?
In the hot seat, hot lava.
There was trust in the relationship, right? You guys always was beefing, but the sex was great. How do you treat that situation then? Wait. I mean, I was posing that for the ladies.
My bad.
But you can go ahead. You can chime in, Mario.
He's trying to save his ass.
I'm just saying. Like,
I'm just kidding.
Now, I'll answer this right now. As a girl, right now, I'll tell you this. Sex is sex. We run off emotion. We females. You know what I mean? We run off that emotion. So yeah, the sex game could be crazy. But we could find another nigga with the same sex game or even better. But do we have that same connection emotionally?
Right.
Nah, you don't get that shit. Because let me tell you something. Us girls,
uh-oh,
we get stimulated. Not by looks. You guys do. Y'all see a girl, you see ass, you see titties. The girl have an ugly face.
I could
y'all
care
like
less
that
about
shit.
A good-looking
we
guy.
We don't. We look up here.
Church.
The nigga, he got to stimulate us mentally.
Church.
Amen.
He got to be funny.
Church.
Like, we like
church.
Little things like
be
that.
Sweet.
That's what turns us on. All
right, can I ask one question?
Little shit
amen.
Like that, and it'll be niggas like that that'll charm a girl and will take your fucking
amen.
Girl.
Amen.
Just like
I got
that.
One. I got
just like
I got
that.
A question.
Amen.
I know. I know a lot of.
I've been with lots of ugly.
I've been with a lot of ugly.
How the fuck you doing?
And really?
I'm how you're doing?
Yeah. I'm telling you that a lot of ugly.
And that's the person you're with the longest. That's the person you can talk to.
To me, they'd be the most beautiful. I'd be like, oh my god, baby, let me kiss your big ass nose.
What?
Exactly.
That's very true.
Yo, well, it's so true.
I don't
it's
know so if I'm considered, and this is a story I remember. I'm sure you don't remember this. I don't know if I'm considered ugly or cute. I think I'm cute, but whatever.
I don't know.
I remember Sasha came, not Sasha, I'm sorry. Yaris came here a long time ago. It was five years ago, right? You don't remember it. I'm sure you went through so many experiences, but I remember this, and I've been waiting to get on this show to talk about this shit. So,
let it out, let it out.
Right here. She said right
lava.
There.
In here?
You
know, they in here?
In here.
No, I've been here before.
Yeah.
Years ago.
So, you know, she was sitting at that table, sitting there looking all, you know, looking all nice. So, I popped the mint in my mouth, thought I was doing the breath check. I done stepped to her, but she played me and gave me the email. I'm like, oh, shit.
Do you expect her to give you her number?
Yeah, but listen, let me tell
we
you
had a
something.
Great conversation. I
not
thought
every
I was in
day,
there.
Not every day you going to be lucky, okay?
I guess.
Sometimes us girls.
What if I was dealing with someone at the time?
Might have been.
Might have been.
No, but you see.
We had a great conversation, though. I thought.
I don't
you
remember.
Gave me the impression like I was about to get the number.
You see, that's what's wrong with men. Like, they think because you say hi, if you say thank you, that's an opportunity to, like, we don't, you know, like.
Nah. But then if we
she
don't say
nice.
Shit to y'all,
she
we a
was
bitch.
Not, no, she was she
man,
was
listen,
nice.
I feel glad cool. that you did not. I mean, I thought she was going to say something else.
Oh,
I
no,
thought
no,
you
were
like, yo, she said I'm ugly, and she said
nah,
this.
Nah, nah. She was nice, and she was mad cool. I just was like, damn, I got the email?
Yeah.
I tried to hit the email up, no response.
Oh, that's crazy.
I just wanted to tell that story.
That was a true story.
I got
story,
a new
though.
Email.
True story.
What?
It's a Yahoo email. I got it in my phone.
He said it's a Yahoo
back
email.
Back then there was no Twitter, so now you got Twitter, you got all that.
So, I mean, not every day you're going to get lucky over there, okay? You know, sometimes
it might be your lucky
we
day
try to
day,
be
you
nice
know.
To the guys, you know.
So the moral of my question is, yes. You could be an ugly, funny nigga, and you're winning.
Abso-fucking-lutely.
Wow.
Wait, no, wait.
Why do you think
let's,
that guy's
let's alter in? This a bit. Let's alter this a bit. You can be a
that
ugly,
guy's the funniest
funny,
people in the world.
Ambitious, goal-oriented, family-oriented. There's more to it. It's not like, okay, you...
This is your funny.
You're
like your
funny
email.
And you're cool, but you're homeless. No. You know what I mean? Like,
ladies, by the way, I'm not beat for no relationship right now. Can we be friends, anybody? I just want to be friends.
Aww.
I need a new friend.
Friends with benefits, of course.
No, of course. Just friends with anything.
I'm not messing with y'all.
They say that women are into security and men are into beauty. You know, that's what attracts us.
Yes.
And that's what I'm telling you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree with that.
You know? And
even
and
if you're ugly and you're secure, it's sexy. You
yeah,
know?
I agree with that.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
And if you're
I had
dressed
a question,
nice
but I
too.
Forgot.
That helped.
My question. But yeah, you guys have been fucking awesome. Like, I want to sit here all day and talk to y'all, but unfortunately, we have
so
another.
You guys,
get the fuck out
so
of here.
Really quick. Do you have like booking info
yes.
so, like that?
Yes.
You know, anybody that's
you
trying
guys
to book
can contact
check out
us.
Give them your Twitter again too.
You can there you go.
Yep.
You can contact us at teeterbroboys@gmail.com. That's where you can contact us. Our email. You can check out our website teeterbroboys973.com. You can hit us on Twitter @teeterbroboys. I'm @ShamariTheGreat.
@teeterbrohouse.
Sharon Jeremy.
And y'all don't got one yet.
No, you don't need nothing yet. You're 10 years old. You stay being 10. And stay in school, too. I'm not playing with you.
Oh, no, that's a big requirement.
If he'll do good in school, period, he will not be allowed in the studio.
First of all, it's kind of late for you to be out anyway.
Yeah, summer vacation.
Oh, okay. Because I was about to say, I forgot how the school thing goes. But
well, thank you
good.
For coming
thank
through.
Thank you, yes. Thank you so much for coming.
I appreciate it.
Oh, thanks for having us all day. Pop's the man,
Jazzy?
Man.
Yeah.
Pop's the man right there, man.
We're ready for our next host.
Jazzy getting music ready. So
she's getting music ready.
Acapulco.
Acapulco.
It is.
Really quick. Oh,
Acapulco?
That's what I said. Hold on.
No.
You ready, Mo?
You got jazz up there. Come on, you nigga. What about me, dog?
Oh, we got Jazzy over there.
Yo.
We gonna let y'all
do. Hold on.
Okay, I see you, Jazzy. Let me actually see you.
Check this out. Check this out. We gonna let the Tito Bird boys spit a little something. Gonna give my co-host and myself a little break. Moschino a break. We got Jazzy Joy setting up. We got both cameras linked up right now, so you can see her cutting and mixing.
Yeah,
you can see the moho. Oh, you like that? Yeah, we about to get loud. I'm gonna let the Tito Bird niggas do their thing. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, yo. Turn my mic up a little bit. Yo.
Turn them off.
You ready?
Turn his headphones up.
Yeah. I don't say I'm getting nice no more, I'm getting cheddar. I don't call hoes hoes no more, I call them sweater. Shout to my brother Jera, it's the end of an era, the start of a new wave. We ballin' while you ain't. See the Burl boys, nigga, we the pilots. You think you fly? We the ones flying. And 2 Chainz like 2 Chainz. With your bitch tryin' to kick it like Liu Kang. TB4L, I need a Neptune beat cause I be for real. Make a long story short when I'm in my zone. Thugs on for hoes, make her chew my bone. Hey world, big H-O-U. Like the green bottle soda, that's how I do. It's CMG, not CMB, but I'm young plus money, 20 plus 3. They say my first shit sound like the best of, and my worst shit better than your best of. Me and Coco still kick it, now that's love. Niggas sleeping on the team, better rest up. Shit, cause we up all night, nigga. Party hard, I'm a white nigga. One time for the motherfucking crew. Swagger get swagged on, that's how we do. 23 years old, ignorant as shit. More money, more clothes, keep these women on my dick. Life like a movie, pilled up while I'm working. Like pills and boobies, gotta keep I'm perky, lot of women watching, most of them be lurking. House got the juicing, they be so thirsty. Slaving in the stew, put a whipping on the beat. I ain't ever been a pussy, but I land up on my feet. They wanna see us fall like Kodo, but we gon' stay on top. My niggas is like a logo. Mari, that's my man, that's my dog. Kodo, four fingers.
Well, listen. Tito Bird boys, they still here. They about to go do some business, too. Jazzy Joyce, well, give Jazzy the mic right quick, y'all. Welcome to the show, Jazzy.
Thank you. I'm happy to be in the house. Hold up, I'm going
to
stop the
movie. We're happy to have you in the house. Look at the light. Yeah, tell us, Sasha.
We happy to have you.
Thank you, beautiful ladies. And I know Sasha already, but the other two, I don't know you. I didn't commit your name to memory. So say... Lonnie Blair and Yaris. Nice to meet you both.
Nice meeting you.
Thank you. We're gonna have some fun.
We're gonna have you in the hot seat.
Yes. I'm not
tell
worried.
Tell him,
Sasha. Don't get rock. I'm gonna let you rock, Jazzy.
Hold on. I'm not connected over here.
Yeah.
We gotta strap this little sucker onto the seat. She gets a little crazy.
Before I come down into the hot seat, since y'all do have the Teterboro brothers here,
yeah.
We did something together on my album. I kind of like just hijacked a song. Oh. I was like, I got introduced to it by 40 Cal from out here in Jersey. Shouts to DJ 40 Cal.
Yeah.
And give Sharon the mic, please. And yeah. we just gonna do it right here. You want what you want me to do? Drop the instrumental or drop the track?
Whatever you want to do.
All right. So I'm gonna drop the instrument because I just asked because a lot of times MCs perform over the lyrics. Like you pay all this money for these concerts, and they rapping over the record. So drop it with the instrumental and watch how we do this. This is called Swag It Out.
Wow.
And this is originally his record.
She liked the way I swag it out.
It's not totally mixed,
I said
but
she liked the way I swag it out. She liked the way I swag it out. I said she liked the way I swag it out. Swag it out.
What'd you say?
Swag it out. Swag it out.
Swag. Swag.
Swag it out.
Off top radio, see the Burl boys in the building.
Swag it out. Swag it out.
She liked the way I lean with it. My Dougie. I swag it out. She love me, and now that I got cheese, all the big girls wanna hug me. My jewelry looks so good that it make them look ugly. And then I'm like, whoa, I swag it out. I take her to the crib, put it in her mouth.
In her mouth.
Wake up the next morning, then I kick her out.
Kick her out.
And never call her back. Huh. Now I'm talking about.
Uh-huh.
Whoa.
I said she liked the way I swag it out. Swag it out.
Uh-huh.
Swag it out.
It's not quite mixed, but you know we.
Swag it out.
Okay.
Swag it out.
Pay attention. Pay attention. Pay attention.
She liked the way y'all.
Diddy bop. You heard me.
You heard me.
I swag it out. She thirsty.
She thirsty.
They hating on me. They worry.
They worry.
See the Borough Boys, we fly out of Jersey.
Jersey.
I'm on the court leaning like I'm clumsy.
Clumsy.
Said I was ghost, got makeup on my rugby.
Word.
Like, come on, baby.
That's worry, but they call me Mr. Dougie. And then I'm like, whoa.
Like,
I said she like the way I swag it out.
Hey.
Swag it out.
Hey.
Swag it out.
Swag.
Swag.
Swag it out.
It's my
swag.
Turn, right?
Swag.
Oh, I fell. It's all right. Spin. Your verse.
Middle, I call that pussy moaning. She all thick now, but she used to be bony.
Then I'm like, whoa.
Those ain't thoughts, any money. No plies, I got plenty money. Y'all niggas looking funny. Can't take nothing from me. Sharon, Jeremy, it's only one
I
me.
I said she liked the way y'all swag it out. Swag it out.
I done fell and all that, it's all good. We live. Boobies a little bruised up, but it's all good.
Oh, she liked the way y'all
spend that money. Never act funny. Always smell good. Never looking bummy. Take her out, treat her nice. Reply to her text. When I do it, she say, Jazzy, you the best. Hell no. Wait a minute. Don't try to gas me up. You mistake me for a sucker, bitch. You got me. Matter of fact, where were you when all the chips were down there? Every day? You wanna come around like, whoa. I said she liked the way I
swag it out.
Swag it out. That's so.
Okay.
This is not being biased. This is not being nothing. These guys will tell you I absolutely hated this song. I swear to you.
You did?
I lie to you now. I hated this song to the bottom of my heart. But after Jazzy's voice, after Jazzy's verse, I swear to God, just because she swagged it more than you. You my mans. I love you 100 grand, but she just bodied you. That was hot.
Stop it.
Power to you, Jazz.
Power to you. No, I kind of just hijacked the situation and jumped on it.
No, you hijacked it. You hijacked it. You took it with box cutters and grenades, and you blew the shit up. Like, you ain't just hijacked it.
So I thank y'all, and I guess we're going to keep it moving and get into a situation, and then I'm going to be in the hot seat.
Of course, of course.
I don't know. I think Jazzy... Huh? Jazzy is a little rapper, too. I don't know.
Yeah, you're going to get her to spit.
We're
going to get her to spit.
We're going to do all of that. Be in the hot seat. We're going to ask
get,
all that.
Well, check this out. It's off-top radio. Go ahead, baby. Go ahead.
So that's it. No more. We got Jazzy.
No, she about to rock right now. Yeah. I was about to go to it. More fire right now.
It's ladies' night.
Ladies' night.
It's ladies' night.
Okay.
Jazzy, woo! Play something for the. Come on, play something for the ladies.
Tell me what have you
just
been
get
being
in
deprived?
It. We want you to get
this
in
some
it.
Sexy TLC shit.
Okay.
Let me.
No.
Yaris is not in love right now. What do you want?
Yaris just want you to go in.
Yaris wants.
What you want? Some
shake that booty.
Pop that new French.
She doesn't have that.
I didn't come ready to make you pop that.
We want to hear some love music. Because you're about to be in the hot seat. We're going to ask you all types of questions. So.
Now, okay. You know what, Jazzy? Rock out.
All right.
Rock
no,
out.
I want to play something.
I personally don't do that.
I don't do that.
We want you to do what you do.
The little tongue between the teeth.
The little tongue between the teeth? What that mean?
Just did it, and that's an international move right there.
Hey, let's get it.
Once again, it's off top radio, off top TV.com.
That's when they get it, they do that.
We got Jazzy Joyce on the ones and twos.
When they feel like they're getting it.
We live, we got the Tina Burrows in the building. We're going to get into a little mix right now.
Jazzy Joyce, take it away.
In mine, I spin. In mine, I spin. Hey. In mine, I spin. I'm riding around, no demon. It's mine, I spin. It's mine, I spin. It's mine, I spin.
I'm riding around, no
demon. I am smoking on exotic. My girl ain't got no stomach. Hey. Every time we hey. Have sex, she always ask me for a honor. I ask her, is she working? She ask me, do I want it? I say, when I went to school, bitch, money, what a subject. I'm riding around, no demon.
Let's get it.
Round around, I'm getting it.
Let's get it.
Round around, I'm getting it. It's mine, I spend it. I'm round around, I'm getting it.
Up top.
Round around, I'm getting it.
Yes.
Round around, I'm getting it. It's mine, I spend it.
Sadie.
It's mine, I spend it.
Yes.
It's mine, I spend it.
Uh-huh.
It's mine, I spend it. I'm round around, I'm getting it. It's mine, I spend it. It's mine, I spend it. It's mine, I spend it. I'm round around, I'm getting it.
Let's go.
I'm riding around my side of town. Boxing gloves, I beat the trial. I had the coke, I had a smile, I had a coat for every style. Yeah. Crocodile, the gator type. I'm allergic to the hater type. I take your wife, give her back. 9 months after that,
similar.
Hey. Same mama's baby's daddy, maybe.
We party.
When we had sex, I was in a Mercedes.
Turn this up.
And I ain't crazy, but if that's my baby, then we gonna have to name the little baby Mercedes. Money that hey. I'm making, hey. I don't see you hey. Like I'm blind.
Yeah.
Rather spend money, all baby, I don't spend time. My pockets. On
you see the Mohawk, she go by the name of Jazzy Joyce, baby.
All my cars got gas.
What you doing?
I'm riding around, hey. I'm getting it.
I'm getting it.
Riding around, I'm getting it.
We getting it.
Riding around, I'm getting it. Hey. It's mine, baby. I spend it. I'm riding around, hey. I'm getting it. I'm riding around, hey. I'm getting it. I'm riding around, I'm getting it. It's mine, I spend it. It's mine, I spend it.
Yeah.
It's mine, I spend it.
Uh-huh.
It's mine, I spend it. I'm riding around, I'm getting it. It's mine, I spend it. It's mine, I spend it. It's mine. Hey,
off top radio. Yeah,
I'm riding around on my side of town with my dubs up and my window down. Hey. It's the king, homie. I'm on one. I'm sucking, no, they don't want none. Said it reppin' that one, son. Bank here. Sell the hill. I'm on Simpson Road and I'm going over to pick up some dope from in Adamville. My seat white and my paint tight. Spray candy red, the same at the wheel. Got a bag of pill in my stash spot. Steady whipping the rack side. Got a quarter mil in my Louis bag if you wanna know what that sack bite. Still rep for them half nights. Try me, homie, you ass out. I got driver's roll, my dental tag, and a cool shit. New kicks, super sport on deuces. Bumping that trap music. I'm super paid, I'm Gucci. Two cute chicks who do tricks. Stay out of my business.
Well, I'm riding around, I'm getting it. Y'all know what it is. Shout out to DJ Mosquito. I'm in the building, Jazzy Joyce. Let's see what the situation is. What did I do wrong here? Oh, I know what I did wrong. It's all good. Yeah. Never scared of these type of situations. Let's go. It's what we do. Off top radio, off top TV. Log on, tell a friend. I'm in the building. I'm gonna be in the hot seat later.
I might be too strung out on compliments. Overdosed on confidence. Started not to give a fuck and stop fearing the consequence. Drinking every night because we drink to my accomplishments. Faded way too long, I'm floating in and out of consciousness. And they saying I'm back, I'd agree with that. I just take my time with all this shit, I still believe in that. I had someone tell me I fell off, ooh, I needed that. And they wanna see me pick back up, well, where'd I leave it at? Exaggerated things, now I got it like that. Tuck my napkin in my shirt, cause I'm just my
log on, like tell that. A friend to log on,
well, that you don't
we are here.
Like that, you gon' make someone around me catch a body like that.
Oh, don't do it.
Please don't do it, cause one of us goes in and we all go through
shout
it.
Shout out to all the Geminis out
money,
there.
So Drizzy gon' pay it, those my brothers.
My B-day in 6 days.
Say it, that's just something they know.
Let's go.
They know. Yeah, they know, yeah. That the real is on the rise. Fuck them other guys. I even gave them a chance to decide. Now it's something they know. They know. Yeah, I be yelling out money over everything. Money on my mind. Then she wanna ask when it got so
uh-huh.
Tell her I apologize, happened over time. She says they missed the whole Drake, girl.
I think I might take it back a little bit.
If they don't get it, they'll be over you.
Uh-huh.
The new shit that you got is overdue.
I wanna go back.
Better do what you supposed to do. I'm like, why I gotta be all that? But still I can't deny the
let's go.
Duck if you buck. take it back. Go back. Why not? Why not? Every Thursday, 8 to 11, tell a friend to log on right here. Y'all know what it is. If you in your house rocking, tell somebody to log on and bounce with us.
Yeah, well, I'm a cat-toned pistol holding nigga on your damn street. Stopping, jumping, bumping, every car off in this damn thing. Throwing the balls, I pack these holes and screaming and bleeding from their nose. But when we start, it's where we make them niggas hit the flow. Ain't no game off in this thing. We be deep off in your party. Call my niggas, get it started. And with niggas, be the hardest. So if
I don't care where you from,
my name matches like a hoe. Punch them dead.
All the ladies that got us on, sing it.
Yeah, we nucky and bucky and ready to fight.
Follow us on Twitter at DJ Moschino, at DJ Jazzy Joy.
Say
he built. Hey. 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 You knucking and bucking out there. Shouts to the Jersey crew. Shouts to everybody around the world.
Yeah, yeah.
New York, what's up? What up?
Yeah.
What up? Nuh. Middle finger up.
Come on.
Put it up.
Okay.
What you say? What you say?
Okay.
What you say?
Okay.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Planet TV.
Okay.
Off Top Radio.
Okay.
Off Top TV.
Okay.
They call me Jazzy Joy.
Okay. You white up, put it up, nigga. I don't give a fuck. Shaking your ass, put it up, bitch. I don't give a fuck. Breaking bricks in the VI. I don't give a fuck. Talking shit.
Big shout out to thisis50.com.
Yep.
Hey.
Wait a minute, y'all. Oh, hey.
G-Man.
What?
We in here.
What?
We can get the drama, but we don't care. It's going down, cause I'm around. 56, you know how I get down.
What you say?
What up, blood?
Uh-huh.
What up, cuz?
Uh-huh.
What up, blood? What up, gangsta? What up, blood? What up, cuz? What up, blood? What up, gangsta?
Hey.
I walk around like I
got
that's on my chest. Now,
hey.
Send me all in the vessel.
Let's go to
try not to say nothing to DA.
We in Queens with this one. I'm standing in Jersey. I'm from the Bronx.
Okay.
Money, I can't get
but why not go to Brooklyn like this?
Let's go
to Brooklyn.
BK.
Rough Riders.
What up?
Swiss beats.
Off top.
Yeah.
Jigga.
What's my motherfucking name?
Jigga.
And who I'm rolling with, huh?
My nigga.
Come on.
Niggas better get it right.
Bitches better get
it right. Come on.
Jigga.
What's my motherfucking name?
Jigga.
And who I'm rolling with, huh?
My yes, nigga. On Top Radio.
Right. On Top, y'all.
Hey. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Say it again, man.
Yes, sir.
One more time.
Bring it back.
Hey, let's go.
My watch talk for me, my whip talk for me, my gat talk for me. Bam.
What up, homie?
My watch saying hi, shorty, we could be friends. My whip saying quit playing.
Bitch, get in.
Earring saying we can hit them all together. Shorty, it's only right that we ball together. I'm in the bigger things, y'all niggas, y'all know my style. Your wrist bling, bling, my shit
bling, bow. Damn.
Hey, y'all know how I do. Uh-huh. Y'all know what it is. Promoter, stop fronting. Holla at me. Let's get this money.
Yep.
At DJ Jazzy Joyce.
Yes.
On Twitter.
Yeah.
Everybody, it's Off Top Radio.
Yeah. What y'all wanna do? Wanna be ballers, shot callers, brawlers. Booby dipping in the bins with the
spoilers.
On the low from the Jake and the Taurus. Trying to get my hands on some grants like Horace. Yeah, living the raw deal. Three
course meals, spaghetti, fettuccine, and veal. But still, everything's real in the field. And what you can't have now, leave in your will. But don't knock me for trying to bury 7-0 over in Rio de Janeiro. Ain't nobody's hero, but I wanna be heard.
On your hot 9-7 every day, that's my word. On your hot 9-7 every day, that's my word. In 6 days, it's my birthday.
Hey.
In 6 days, it's my birthday.
Hey. Ow!
Go Jazzy, it's your birthday.
We gon' party like it's your birthday. We gon' sip Bacardi like it's your birthday.
Shouts to all the Geminis.
We don't give a fuck, it's not your birthday.
What up, what up?
Hey,
hey. Okay, the ladies wanted some, right? I got something for the ladies.
I got something for the niggas. Fuck them other niggas, down for my niggas. Fuck them other niggas, cause I'm down for my niggas. Fuck them other niggas, cause I ride for my niggas. I die for my niggas.
This is for the ladies.
Honey, honey, I can see the stars all the way from here. Can't you see the glow on the window?
Are y'all ready for me down there?
I can feel the sun whenever you're near.
Shout out to the ladies at home.
I just melt away.
Hey.
All the ladies getting dressed, getting ready to go out to the club tonight. We're here every single Thursday night, 8 to 11 p.m. Eastern time.
That's right.
5 to 8 out west. If you're in Japan, you might be getting up to start your work day. It's motherfucking 11 a.m. in Japan. Friday morning, but it's Thursday night in New York, baby. We're getting down, Sassy Joy.
Hey.
Shout out to the whole Off Top fam, the whole gang, East to West Coast, what it is. Shout out to everybody out there in PA. Shout out to Sasha grabbing me by the back. Hey, bro. I back it up on you. Hey, bro.
Hey,
bro. Hey, bro.
You know what it is? We right here. Off top. Off top,
off top,
off top,
off top,
off top, radio.
Yep. Now I can feel the wind whipping past my face.
First two.
As we dance the night away. And boy, your lips taste like champagne. As I kiss you again and again and again and again.
Hey,
no music. Why I'm smiling out from ear to ear.
Yes. One more time, let's go. Ladies, come on.
Working things out up here, everything off top, you already know. DJ Jazzy Joyce on the ones and two. And it's seven, baby. Come on.
Hey.
If you're at home in the house, turn your speakers up, tell your neighbors, I'm sorry. It's an off top thing. We just jamming out. Shout out to everybody in Harlem, Brooklyn, the BX, Queens, Staten Island,
all my fat niggas.
Hey. Jersey. Connecticut, what up, CT? I see you. Virginia, what's good? Moving and grooving. Delaware, North Carolina, South Carolina. Come on.
All that shit.
Shout out to everybody down there in Georgia, Florida, Texas, Michigan, Tennessee, Vegas, LA. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to homie Al Harrington. He hit me on the check-in. He out there in Denver. Denver Nuggets ain't in the finals, but hey, fuck it. Hey, if you know the score right now to the game, send me a tweet at PopsNYC. We shout you out. We got two more songs with Jazz. We're going to get into this interview right quick.
I want to hear this. I want to hear this.
Go ahead, Jazz. What you got, baby?
Oh, yeah.
Shit.
Slow down.
This is my
slow down.
Shout out to everybody out west. Talk to him, Jazz. That's your shit, baby?
Yeah.
Hey.
Hold up.
I need to talk to y'all.
Go ahead.
Sometimes it takes a minute for my East Coast people to catch on to,
talk to
stuff elsewhere.
Right.
This right here?
Huh.
This shit right here?
This shit right here?
Did you feel your toes? We out here trying to function.
Function, right.
Yes. Off top.
Right as that.
Jazzy Joyce.
Jazzy Joyce, y'all.
Yep.
Hey, try this. Guaranteed turn square to a poppin'. You ain't down, I'm a bop. I ain't got time for playing, I'm just saying. We out here trying to function. 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 I ain't got time for playing, I'm just saying, man. We out here trying to function. 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 Function. I ain't got time for playing, I'm just saying, man. We out here trying to function.
We out here trying to function, boo. You fucked off my high, get about my mix. You messing up my vibe, I'm trying to get some crap.
Get some crap.
Put it in my ride, take it to the rinse. I'm toasting the sloppy off of a broccoli Bacardi. 151 out my body, about that green like wasabi. Like in Bari, we mobby, we bossy back to fuck off. Getting money, my hobby, not getting money, it's not. The rappers I listen to is E40 and Pop. I'm having my revenue play, I'm having this guap. I'm on my man, I stay laced and groom, I spray myself with sucker repellent. My new, not perfume, not anything you got. I can sell to the hustler, think I can't.
Think I
get the gap, sell the White House, black paint.
Black
word candy, S-L-A-N-G. Thinking about taking $1 million insurance policy out of my mouth.
Hey, try this. Guaranteed turn square to a bop.
Hey,
you ain't down, bop.
Shouts to everybody to trying to find a way to be okay. We out here trying to function.
That's right.
Got bad, they ratchet. Bet the ding make them sing like an ad lib. And all this money, watch me flip it like a backflip. I'ma go to work on the no practice. All my real niggas in the photo. Bottles in the air, we don't care about no. Yeah, shout out my D-Lo. Girl, I know you want to, but I need about 3-5. Yeah, pretty girls in the crib. I know they all models, that's just how I lit. I'm like, whoa, when she do the split. And when she throw it back, down. My niggas in the club with the folly, we just with the folly. We like what's happening in water.
Hey,
function ain't no competition, killing the opponents.
And no scheme, no baby.
Just for the moment, yikes.
Hey, try this. Guaranteed turn square to a bop. You ain't down, bop. I ain't got time for playing, I'm just saying, but we out here trying to function. 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 We out here trying to function.
We out here trying to function. One more joint off my album. I did this song with this young man called, he goes by the name of Vane. He's out there on Twitter. And this is another joint off my album. It's kind of a world premiere because I didn't play it.
Okay.
I never played it before, so listen. It's called Laughing.
Exclusive.
Laughing Party, Dancing and Drinking. We're going to shoot the video for this summer. So, ladies, if you're in the club with your best friend and if it's her birthday, point to her. Shout to Vane. Fellas. Off top radio, baby. If it's your homie's birthday, get him a drink and let's get drunk. Come on!
Hey! Woo! Having a good time, laughing, party, hey. Dancing and drinking.
Hey.
Laughing, party, hey. Dancing and drinking. Hey!
All right, I like that part.
Having a good time, laughing, party, hey. Dancing and drinking.
Hey.
Laughing,
hey.
Party,
hey.
Dancing
okay.
And
now if you been tuning in vain, then you know just how I fall. Selection of dimes in my phone, who do you suggest that I call? Baby,
all
we
right.
Laughing, party, dancing and drinking. If you about a good time, then let's lengthen. I'ma blow you out and bust it open when I'm thinking. If that pussy good, then we can do it every weekend. I'm a beast. Hoes be all at the bracelet. Top notch diamonds leave them shocked. That's a facelift. Bring your faces. Don P, ecstasy, that's the basic.
Yeah.
Haters couldn't see me with LASIK. She leaned over, toe joints, bang, got a moist. Niggas is mad, I'm in the gym and I'm the girl's choice. You can catch me in the lounge throwing down. Or see me in the club throwing it up. See, we single and we don't give a fuck. So, baby, if you drunk, back it up. I'm grinding on a butt.
Hey,
and
stop.
On
the hey,
hey, yo, DJ, turn this shit up.
Hey!
And what we doing?
Having a good time, laughing, party, dancing, and drinking, laughing, party, dancing, and drinking. Hey!
Get to know it, y'all.
Having a good time, laughing, party, dancing, and drinking, laughing, party,
listen.
Waitress, please bring my bottle of water. That liquor's for someone's daughter, so she can have fun tonight.
Laughing, party, dancing and drinking,
standing on these couches, dancing, rocking back and forth with their hands in the air. Waving like they just don't care. Shouts to all the DJs round the world. It's Jazzy, the rock star. Big shout out to all the DJ crews, no matter. Call the paparazzi, please somebody come take my phone. Take this picture as we laugh, live, drink, and sing along.
Hey,
come on.
Hey,
hey,
hey, having a good time.
Good time. Party, dancing and drinking, laughing, party, dancing.
We trying,
well,
all
right. Having a good time. Laughing,
drinking. Oh my goodness. Jersey.
I like that. I like that. I like that. Word up.
Alright. We here. We here. We here. We here.
Hey, hey.
I hear you, Jazzy.
Downtown.
That was
Thank
nice.
You. Thank you.
You
Top Cat, we good?
I like that. I like that. Word
that
up.
Was nice, Jazz. I ain't here.
You was just having the party of your life over there, Jazzy.
I was right. trying. I was trying. I
tried. That's got a lot of energy, man.
Look, I hold up. I'm gonna keep it 100 with the people. I went to the back for my, you know, my my nightly smoke break.
Yeah.
You know.
Loud.
And Mo came back. Mo was like, yo, y'all gotta come, you know what I'm saying, Jazz. I said, hey bro, I'm over here with Jazz right now. I hear everything she doing, I'll be right back. Shout to DJ Jazzy Joyce, yes. Number one female DJ that I know. Doing her thing. Am I lying?
Uh-huh.
Bro, am I lying, bro?
No, no. You 100%
right. I'm just trying to keep it funky.
Thank
now,
you.
Sitting here, we got the hot couch. That's the hot couch right now. Is this shit on? Because I know y'all got these cordless mics. Y'all niggas.
No, I think my.
Oh, yeah, you.
Mic check.
Oh,
damn.
Come
on. High tech.
Yeah. Mo, swing that, Mo. Send that down. Pause. Listen,
what happened?
Sitting on the couch, you gotta get Ariel your joint, man. Yeah, you know Ariel need that right there. Abiel, pardon. You say it. Say your name for me, homie. Yeah.
Abiel.
Pardon self. Abiel. We got Abiel up in the building. These are the owners and designers and makers, and this day shit. LaVie Clothing, correct?
Yes, sir.
That's it, what it is? Go ahead, Sasha. Talk to the people, man. You know these brothers. Let them know.
We have them here. I mean, I see that you have actually Pro Style. I mean, I don't know. You have a collab with him. You guys.
Well, let's
work
first
with
of
them?
All talk about the history of.
Yeah, yeah, no,
of LaVie.
No, definitely.
Why don't we do that?
Absolutely.
Let's talk about the history of LaVie. I worked with them
it's
before.
Just, yeah, I
had a I worked with you guys. So.
Yes.
So. Who is LaVie and. You know.
LaVie is a brand we started in 2004. Fausto, myself, a female that's not here now, her name is Angie. And, oh, she's just not here.
She had some other shit to do.
And there was a fourth gentleman that I'd rather not disclose the name because he's not with us anymore. But we funded the brand in 2004 and we're here now. And LaVie stands for the life in French. We're a lifestyle brand. We're awesome.
Oh, okay.
And,
okay.
Yeah.
Do you have clothes for us? I just want to get that right off the bat.
Not for girls, unfortunately. We started off men's and women's, but what happened was, right, recession hit. and then women started wearing Forever 21 and H&M, and they stopped wearing. Yeah.
So we just gotta sing and be jealous.
And like clothes for guys is so much more difficult to find.
That's not right.
You know, like guys can't wear the stuff we wear. We could pull off a $5 shirt, but you guys can't.
You know what? I was about to go in on this interview. I like you guys a lot upon meeting you, but I don't want to talk to you no more. So you got clothes for us, okay? That's what makes us want to talk is the clothes.
The good news is
I'm over here jealous, drooling and stuff.
I got good news.
What's the good news?
Eventually, we're gonna bring it back.
Hey, okay. Bring it back now.
Well, that means you have to come back and bring us some clothes.
I got you then. As long as you keep in touch, we got you.
Okay. Yeah, we definitely need. Definitely.
Nice. Let's see those shirts. Oh, look at that.
Nice.
Oh, that pocket right there.
Real nice. Look at the
stripes. I'll turn it around.
Look at the stripes on the
inside. It's like
the
pocket is like dumping something out.
That's the logo.
I like that.
The fly guy.
That is real nice.
Very creative.
Fly guy.
Pops, how... Pops, how hype are you right now?
No, I'm just trying to show the people, man.
No, I mean, aren't you excited?
Oh, it's for men, so I'm already hype. I knew, you know, I'll show the niggas on Twitter 3x.
You gonna wear that to Perfections Wednesday? What's up?
It's a fly little shirt, right? You could wear those with the Jordans.
Yours is gonna be a little tight.
We go to 4X, we got you.
All right, can we purchase this clothing online? Or do you guys have a website? What's the website?
shop.levieny.com. LAVIENY.com. And you know how to spell shop. So shop.levieny.com.
Some people don't, so you have, you know.
shop.levieny.com.
Nice.
May I ask you guys nationality? Price? Because you look a little, I just want to.
I look crazy, but I'm Dominican.
You do look a little crazy.
I'm Dominican. We're both Dominican.
Okay. Anyway,
now, like, what's the price range? Like, you know, so the
price
people
range.
Know.
Is
this something I could buy? Can I buy a shirt with a like, let's say I'm on a
$100 budget.
Day, I want my man to look good. Can I go with $100 and
$100 will get you.
No, what kind of crowd are you guys trying?
Let's answer the questions accordingly.
Okay.
$100 will get you one
sweat. You want to do an interview to yourself?
Two t-shirts, maybe one pair of jeans.
Okay.
That means for
$100?
Huh?
For $100?
For $100.
That's good.
One pair of jeans. Only.
Just
one
pair.
Two t-shirts only. Or one sweater only.
Oh, that's not bad because
you wasn't going to get all that shit.
A pair of jeans costs like $350.
Okay, you can curse. I get it because I thought you meant like...
That's not bad.
$100 to get three things.
We're not
like,
selling,
shit,
out, we're not selling out of Target now. We're look, selling out look. Of Target. We probably not be sitting here because we be rich, but we be selling at a much cheaper price.
That's not bad though. That's not bad.
Yeah, no, I think honestly, if you for those of you who know the V, like it's our stuff is very good quality. So I think it's actually underpriced for what it's worth.
So where did you guys start? How did you guys?
Yeah, how'd y'all link up? Like, are y'all high school brothers?
That's a very long story.
Did you go to school?
Fausto and I actually met through some mutual friends. We did some business together. Like, I was like 18. I'm about to be 28. That was like 10 years ago. Because I'm an airbrush artist also. So we joined forces back like 10 years ago. And we opened up like a little shop where I was airbrushing. And he was selling like clothing, DVDs and stuff like that. That's how we, he was an African. That's how we met. And we were there for a few months and then we kind of went our separate ways. Just because the location we were at, it was only good while school was good. So we went our separate ways. We kind of did our own thing for a while and then the whole clothing line idea came up. So that brought us back together.
So this is how old, this brand?
8 years.
And I understand you're a photographer, right?
Yeah, I also do fashion and commercial beauty photography.
So I want to hear Fausto speak. What's up?
For sure.
Very quiet.
What do you want
to
know?
Just, you know, describe your contribution to the line and what you put forth and all that stuff.
Well, in 2004, I literally created it in my head.
Wait a minute. Your mic is low.
Yo,
there's no bad enough.
You hear me? Right. So in 2004, I literally created Levion out of my brain. It was a brainchild of mine, and I reached out to Sense, which is my partner, obviously. And I know he's so talented, and we just kind of We just kind of linked up and made our dreams come true.
So who came up with the logo?
The logo is... It's actually
everyone's
me.
Taking credit for that. Okay.
He's the logo. I took a picture of him.
Wait.
Pause.
Don't be holding the mic to my face. I took a picture of him. Our other partner drew the wings, and then I put it together.
So that's him.
It's him.
Oh, that's you on the back of the shirt?
It's you flying?
Yeah, that's him.
Were you hanging off a harness?
Actually, I just stood on a chair.
That's interesting. Was this a good question that I asked this? Okay, great.
Yeah, because people don't know that.
Well, that's really cool. I have a question now. You said you're Dominican, right? You Dominican also? Both of y'all Dominican.
Yes.
The name Levee is a French name.
Yeah.
How did we, you know, how did that come about, though? Like, I heard you gave the what Levee means, but I mean, why did you go French? But you know what I'm saying? I'm just talking nationality shit. You know what I mean?
To be honest.
Right.
We had composed a list of names, and we kind of sat down, just went through it, and that's what, from the start, our vision with this brand was, like, luxurious, you know?
Okay.
So, when we went through the list of names, this is the name that popped out, so it's more like luxurious. Like everything else just seemed it didn't click to us.
I mean, honestly, because the clothing line is a lifestyle, it's like what we actually live and do.
So these are Levee jeans right here.
Yeah, Levee jeans, Levee shirt.
Can you stand up?
We got a camera right here, bro, so they can see everything.
Those are some nice jeans.
And that's the shirt on
Turn
too,
around,
right?
Let me see the back pockets.
I mean, we do a lot of details like leather.
It's a nice little chain you got on there too, Chief.
Thank you.
Yeah. No, it's a really nice pair of jeans. What
about the shirt? I like that superficial.
What's
the name?
Trillionaire. I like that. Trillionaire. I'm a trillionaire.
That's good.
I be chilling.
So now that you guys make all this clothes, do you even go ahead and buy clothes?
Luxury, Gucci.
Oh, excuse
stuff
me.
Like that. No, I mean not. It was always you always bought that. It's just I have to really like something. I mean, it don't matter. It could be H&M. It could be Zara.
Because now, if you don't find what you're looking for, you could just create it.
This is. True.
Yeah.
But the thing is that the process to create garments is like a 6-month process. So if I want something right now, I have to go get it. Like if we don't have it in our brand. Truthfully, I still shop outside of Levee. I got a shitload of clothes, but I like me personally, we both do. Like we switch up our style. So like I'm not dressed in streetwear or whatever on a daily basis. Sometimes I like to wear a bow tie and a shirt.
You guys do like streetwear and you guys do... upscale.
There's a mixture in our brand is a mix of both.
One day you want to just chill, you know,
exactly.
Chill with your boys, and then the next day you want to go out on a date with your girl, whatever. Exactly. You know, you gotta.
Another thing we gotta spend money on.
Pop the little collar.
Exactly, it's footwear because we don't do footwear, so like I gotta go out
is
and spend money on
footwear.
Is that
in the works?
It was.
Would you consider
partially?
It?
We would. But our brand has to be at the right state for us to dabble into that. It's a whole different world, the footwear game.
Where are you guys from?
Where do we live? I live
where
in Yonkers.
You
and I was raised.
Like, I would just want to know where did you get this concept of style from? Like,
I grew up in the Heights till I was about 16, and then I moved to Yonkers. But I don't really consider myself from Yonkers, even though I live there. I just sleep there.
And you're from the Heights also? Oh, BX. Okay, so that's where.
Where in the Bronx you from?
I'm from around White Plains, White Plains Road area. The better part. I like to call it the better part. Yeah. I don't live with the ratchet.
They're just having a Bronx moment.
Oh wait, having a Bronx moment. You know?
Are you Jazzy?
Jazzy from the Bronx.
Jazzy
too.
From the Bronx.
What? OBX.
I wasn't.
You kind of from the Bronx too.
Well, I mean, I wasn't raised in the Bronx, but I live there now.
You can throw it up.
Okay. BX in the building.
We in here.
So it's okay. I'm from Jersey.
Where you from?
Always Ross say Heights? Stop that.
Right. So, did you guys go to school for any kind of fashion or anything?
So who sketches? No. Do you have someone that sketches it for you? You're the very nice.
You're the artist.
I went to school for graphic design. I have a BA, but I didn't go to school for fashion.
I did.
Just,
Awesome. We didn't ask you.
Who? But it was easy for me to incorporate what I learned in school graphic-wise to the brand. I design on Adobe Illustrator, so I learned the core foundation of Illustrator
that's
in school.
What it is right there. Like, when I went to school, I went to fashion design, fashion industries. I graduated from there. Our first year, we had to learn on Adobe how to do, like, the actual details, like a collar, a V-neck, like, the whole nine yards. It's really hard, man.
And it's time consuming.
Very time consuming.
Yes.
Very time consuming.
It's hard. You'll be having to get swatches from like Google. Did you ever have to do that?
From
like
Google?
Get swatches or something? But you gotta talk to the microphone.
Well, we love it because we deal with our own factory, so they just send us watches all day and stuff like that.
Do you have to start like with a big budget?
Well, we started with 50 polo.
What is 50 polo?
Literally like polo shirts.
Not me.
I thought that was like slang for like 50K.
But now when you're saying we started off with 50 polo, we understand it's shirts.
I really thought you guys said like 50K.
No, I understand, but well, I want to talk dollar amount. Would you say, because for the people watching, I mean, you know, like
for people that want to start their own line.
Some people want to start their own line.
Y'all not haters, are y'all?
No.
Okay.
Lonnie had to ask.
I don't mean to be a mic hog, but
a mic hog.
Technically. You don't need a lot of money for the beginning process of starting a brand.
Yeah, talk to the viewers. Talk to the viewers. They probably want to open up a line.
They just need to hear me. They don't need to see me.
Okay.
I'm kind of tired.
Yeah,
right
he's
now,
crazy but... looking. He said that
he
earlier.
He don't got time for this. He just wants to interview.
Okay, go.
Really?
It doesn't take a lot of money technically to start, but to maintain and build an actual brand, it takes a shitload of money.
So you have investors and stuff?
Yeah. It takes a shitload of money. So
I have so much questions.
You guys have a lot of questions.
You're in the red seat.
Honestly, the reason why it's red is because it's hot. When we started, it was all out of pocket. We spent up to out of pocket, I'm going to say it. Close to 60 to 80,000 out of pocket.
It's not bad.
Probably a little bit more. This is personal.
Right.
And then it got to the point where now we're in around 400 stores. You got to, you know, feed these stores and all that. So now, you know.
But now you guys are generating money, and now you guys are getting all this.
We're not millionaires, but we're shipping a million.
Right.
The business is doing it.
So do you guys have jobs, or is this all you guys do?
No, this we eat up for this.
It's nice.
Why do I do my
trash?
You don't want to talk about that? Okay.
You bees in the trap?
That's not what she's saying.
Okay.
So you guys are good enough that you don't have to work another job. This is what you guys do.
Yo, let me ask you a question.
Nice.
You have kids?
Yeah,
too. Oh, nice. How old are you? You look about 18.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Good
Yo, okay.
It sounds like subtle holleration to me. A little interview for potential baby daddies.
Yeah!
But I'm just saying. You know what's right.
crazy? One of our first, you know what's crazy? One of our first interviews was with her.
I know.
Oh,
I was going to say.
It was something just like this.
Wow, there's a lot of kawinky things going
when
on. When I looked at the logo, I was like, yo, I remember
that. When we did an interview, I think it was Brooklyn.
Yo, y'all are
hilarious. It was in my mind, I remember
she,
y'all.
She was getting interviewed too, the same
right,
day.
Right, right.
I don't know.
DTF.
Jazzy knows DTF. Them all.
Yeah,
I was at DTF when I was out there. I remember y'all.
And Mano was there too that day.
Yes. I remember the logo, but I didn't want to jump in. But
it's all good.
Pop, are you over there knocking around?
Mess
you up. I'm gonna mess you up over here.
Look, I'm holding this like a big cock.
No,
gently.
You're good.
Gently.
Next question.
Jazzy, we gonna get you in the top seat in a minute because you talking that good one over there.
Next question is, how did you guys find these investors?
Destiny. Now, the fourth guy that's not with us today, he had done some freelance work for these people, design work, and it was early on. And then a few years later, they contacted him to do some more freelance work, and they became aware of what we had going on, and they became
It was a mutual.
Oh shit.
It was a mutual interest. It was a mutual interest, and it's the best. It worked out.
This was destiny.
Yeah.
So do you guys get comparisons to the club now? What happened when the club La Vie came out? Because when I hear La Vie, like before getting to even.
We've been here way longer than La Vie.
No,
so.
I know. But when La Vie started popping, like ooh. When people say La Vie, do people like compare you to the club ever?
Nope.
What does the club have to do with the line?
No, like, that's the first time I heard La Vie, the word was La Vie, the club, before hearing of you guys. I've heard of you guys before.
Right, now I get it.
But, you know.
Honestly, like, it's not, we don't get compared, but people be like, yo, we need to do a fashion show at Club La Vie because it's so
yeah.
Stuff like that, you right. know, things like that, but not really like, I don't know who you're talking
You think
about
they heard you guys' name and then decided to call their club La Vie?
Nah.
You ever think of that? I would.
Honestly, La Vie just means the life. So anything that represents the life, I'm sure, like, you know.
There's a lot of companies out there that use the name. Not clothing lines, but like makeup. I see makeup companies, bag companies.
But you guys were the first.
As far as.
It's all right. You're on our show. We're just going to rock with y'all for now. Yeah.
As far as clothing in the U.S., we're the only brand that goes by the name La Vie.
Her sarcasm is so under the table and just
y'all don't be catching it.
Yeah, I'm over here like I need a helmet.
Lonnie's wild. That's why I keep looking at you. Sorry, Jazzy, I forgot to warn you about this one.
This one is a special one over there.
I love it.
How old is her? How old you know her?
I like it because sometimes they don't get it. I'm like, whoop, okay.
She's been boxing. But anyway,
I do be boxing sometimes.
No, I don't mean to infringe on their time. Go ahead, my brother.
So, guys, talk to us. What's your next step? You know, where y'all going from here? You know, yeah.
What's next? You guys have coats for the wintertime and stuff?
Oh, yeah. I got a coat from y'all. It was my winter coat at one point.
Nice. Was it warm?
It was very warm. Okay. It actually made me sweat a lot.
We're a full-fledged line. We have everything from tank tops to denim,
so when should
shorts,
we be expecting the women's clothes?
Not yet.
When should we be expecting
them? When? I'm going to say 2013 or 14.
Oh, God.
Okay.
It's
I understand. I understand. You got to establish your
time.
Brand
exactly.
first.
It takes time.
Before you can actually go ahead and branch off. Because
you know what it is? It's taken us. The reason why it's taken us more time to merge into the market is because we're not a gimmick brand. From day one, we try to build longevity. And to build longevity, it takes long for you to build something that has that type of foundation. A lot of brands, they're huge
they
in 1 or 2 years, but you don't see them anymore.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? So that's why for us, it's been a slower upbringing, but we're
it's
here
okay.
to stay. You know what
it's
I mean?
Okay.
Like,
yeah.
What name a few stores that we might be able to, like...
I've seen a lot of stores in Fordham, which also...
Yeah, I mean, there's so many stores, I wouldn't be able to tell you off the top of my head, but we do have a store list on our flash site online. So if you go to thebny.com, you'll be able to see all the stores that we're in.
Nice. Do you got any specials coming up? Any sales?
We're constantly doing stuff.
Father's Day sale, maybe?
Yeah. What we have...
Any giveaways? Oh, matter of fact, you guys are going to be Starlets, right?
Yeah.
Starlets on Sunday?
Yes.
Yeah, they're going to do free giveaways, right? I don't know.
For everybody that buys a bottle that day, they're going to get a raffle.
Regulations.
And I don't know, they know we'll raffle out the free clothes.
Okay, so I ain't mad at
that's,
that.
That's what they told
that's
me.
That's cool.
But we with it, though. It's nothing.
Well, do you guys have, Sounds tell good. Everyone your Twitter and all that good stuff, Facebook, you got that?
Our Twitter's at La Vie Clothing. Just go to our website and you can find everything linked on there because I don't know the full link for Facebook or anything. But if you go on our site, thevny.com, you'll be able
to
find
us. He's just over this interview. He's like, I'm tired.
Nice.
I'm ready to go.
I just like to get straight to the point.
Right.
I mean, I'm having a good time. Don't get me
what
wrong.
What sign are you?
I'm a Libra.
He is so funny.
Oh, my God. Yeah. I'm a Libra.
Oh, my
oh
God.
My
we're so
God.
Many. What day?
Oh, my God.
What's your
birthday is September 29th.
I'm the 10th of October.
Anyway, we don't care. It's Gemini month.
Listen.
So what's
your
name?
Oh, you know.
You
just got better right now, but it's cool.
Yeah,
it's
okay.
Bossy.
Well, it's okay. What's yours now?
My Twitter's Future the Ball.
No, your zodiac sign.
Oh, Leo.
No, I just asked a Twitter. I don't care no more about anything else.
Okay.
So, Future_Boss. And no, it was great having you guys. You guys are a pleasure. You're a little tired. It's okay. I've been tired before.
Yeah.
Hard day work.
So, what's we up? About to go to Jazzy? Yeah, what we going?
We going to Jazzy right quick, and then we going to get in the hot seat. It's that
hot
simple.
Seat.
It's,
okay.
That, it's that
thank
quick.
You guys
thank
so
you guys
for
having me.
I don't think Jazzy ready.
Hey, yo, La V, I'm going to come talk to y'all. We're going to take pictures and get everything right, man. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to them for coming through. Thanks for coming through, gentlemen. Definitely. We're going to throw your shit on the site and all that shit. All right? Jazzy Joyce, one time, baby. Check it out. It's Off Top Radio, offtoptv.com. We still in the mix. Turn it up, baby. Jazzy Joyce on the ones and twos. She about to get in the hot seat. Shout out to the brothers from the V Clothing. Yes, sir. Come on.
Rather beat it, dick your girl down, cause I know she really need it. Yeah, I get her wet, wetter than she ever been. Now she telling me that she gonna tell all her friends. I'm like, okay, bring them all along. As long as I can stick my tongue in between the thumb. Yeah,
yep,
I'm nasty, I know you like
what
it.
Two, what two, what up, world?
Baby girl, you gon' bite it. Yeah, I go
your boy Skino, man.
From the back, all step back.
I'm over here with Jazzy Joyce and all that.
Twerk. Yeah, I got stroke, tell me where it hurts.
Got the homies live in the building, know what I'm saying? Pretty ladies and all that.
On my lips,
Lonnie Blair.
Tastes good to me. Put it,
Yari Sanchez. Put it, Sasha the Valet.
Put it in your gut.
Yep.
I'll be the pussy up. I'll be the pussy up.
Tell me she want it, she know I know that she with it. She moan and groan when I get it, she tell me lick it, I did it. Sexy thing, enough to make a nigga go crazy. Man, do crazy. Then we get to talking and touching, we get to licking and sticking. Now you know what we doing when you're around and we missing. We go to perfect positions, we get it popping. I listen too much pleasure to measure. She got the power to beat me, make her wanna get to me in a major way. Jackpot, jump shot, a nigga fade away. I mean, way away. I be on that elite shit, that HBK heartbreak kid freak shit. From the front to the back, from the left to the right side, we worldwide. From the east to the west side, get it, girl, that's right. Let's rise.
I beat the pussy up. I beat the pussy up. I beat the pussy up. I beat the pussy up.
Rather beat it, lick your girl down, cause I know she really need it. Yeah, I get her wet, wetter than she ever been. Now she telling me that she gonna tell all her friends. I'm like, okay, bring them all along. As long as I can stick my tongue in between the thong. Yeah, I'm nasty, I know you like it. Lick the bottom lip, baby girl, you gon' bite it. Yeah, I go deep, I love it from the back. Arch that back, make that ass clap. Make the pussy squirt, yeah, I got stroke. Tell me where it hurts, spread them legs. Little mommy, watch you work. Tell me what it is, show me what it could be. Pussy on my lips, juice box tastes good to me. Put it on my tongue, fill me on up. Put it in your gut, get the pussy up.
I beat the pussy up.
She ain't got to tell me she want it. She know I know that she with it. She moan and groan when I get it. She tell me lick it. I did it. Sexy thing, enough to make a nigga go crazy. Man, do crazy. Then we get to talking and touching. We get to licking and sticking. Now you know what we doing when you're around and we missing. We go to perfect positions. We get it popping. I listen too much pleasure to measure. She got the power to beat me. Make her wanna get to me in a major way. Jackpot, jump shot, a nigga fade away. I mean, way away. I be on that elite shit. That HBK heartbreak kid freak shit.
I beat the pussy up.
Bobby.
I'm me, you know I'm a big dog. I dive in the head first like a free fall. Big wood, thicker than a tree log. How to bouncing on the dick like a seesaw. Baby, I'm raw, like I don't use protection. And we can get it right here in the VIP session. I wanna fuck you right here like Irk say. Mr. Ice with the cream, no dessert place. Scream my name, baby, I'm Skipper. Just one dish, I'd reach it for my zipper. It's down, I'm a dicker. You can pick her up or I'll deliver. Panties in the way, if the new one, I'ma rip them. I go hard in the paint. Boyfriend mugging all hard cause he can't. 91 premium, all in the tank. I deposit that dick, I call it a sperm bank.
Mic check. One, two.
I got a feeling this is going to be a hilarious
situation. And y'all got her on the hot couch. She's not even in the hot seat.
Hold on, Jazzy.
She's on the hot couch.
Thank you. I need an I don't want to fight over the music. I need to
We're going to turn. We're going to let you talk, baby.
Turn it off and switch off.
Okay.
We can start.
Because we're going to have a talk. we're gonna have a talk about
I'm school. Nervous.
We're going to wrap it up and we're going to have a talk.
I'm nervous.
And we're going to have a talk about females and what do females want. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's nice.
We're going to talk about that.
That's nice. I'm nervous.
Yeah, that's nice.
I feel like the first time, the first day I ever met Sasha. It was at the premiere for the movie.
Yes.
And she came flying out because this is my second time actually seeing her, but we communicate since the day we met. Mm-hmm. And she came flying out and she tried not to be noticed, but I like stepped and
tripped her.
No. I stepped in her path of, she was focused. She was like, I'm getting the fuck out of here. I'm just going to keep my head straight. I don't want these people to realize it's me.
I've always liked that.
No, I know, but I really.
It's funny.
You don't have to tell me that. I knew. I was like, but I think that's the characteristic of most beautiful women.
They usually
move very early in the morning or very late at night, and they move fast.
Yes.
I'm serious.
I'm little, but I'm fast.
No, I know.
I'm like Speedy Gonzalez. I'm like,
that?
Yo,
what is
I'm
that
going
right
to point A to point B, and I'm just
wait,
getting
what is
there.
That analogy? Very early in the morning or very late at night?
Because most people, you know how to say the early bird gets the worm and everything?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Like, because they're usually in captivity at the prime hours, meaning somebody has their attention. Somebody's courting them, taking them.
I like the way you're putting this.
I like that.
I like the way she's putting this.
I like the way.
I like this.
You know what I mean?
The analogy is real cool.
Thank you. And then in the early mornings is usually after the festivities and y'all trying to get to the next spot before motherfuckers get up to go to work and all of that. So it's like that pre-dawn.
You seem like you give good advice.
I've a lot of people kind of
do people like go to you and be like, you know what, Jazzy, and then they just fucking 15 minutes pass and they just told you that their whole fucking life story. You get that?
I get that a lot. You gotta realize I've been interviewing people for over a decade when I was at Hot 97, and I have that. It's a gift. I have that way of kind of making people feel comfortable because immediately in speaking to me, you realize I'm intelligent and we could touch on some things besides surface.
Now how long were you in Hot 97 for?
I was blessed to have a career for 15 years.
Wow.
Wow.
To not go to broadcasting school
Nice. And just come up from nothing. I'm really
now,
a story.
Now, how did you even get this opportunity?
Veteran.
I'm born and raised in the Boogie Down Bronx.
BX.
Yes.
Yeah, Iris, it's okay.
Okay.
DJ.
I gotta move to the Bronx now.
Come on over.
Come on down.
I don't think the Bronx ready for me.
I don't think so.
I think we
either.
Are.
Come to my
part of the Bronx.
Jersey got this little
mama.
Yeah,
Jersey got me.
But if I mean police officers, can y'all please stop giving her speeding tickets? Cause I just got a ticket today. I know the early morning.
She's
a little menace.
Another one, Sash?
Let me finish answering the question. I was doing the mixtape thing, and then I was hot in the streets at that time. And my manager at the time kept hitting Hot 97, kept hitting them. And around 94, I was like, no more 94, because the fucking Africans was bootlegging my shit crazy. And I was like, it's either I go to start beating them up or I leave it alone. So my motto became, no more 94. And then Hot 97 reached out, said, here, we got this opportunity. What you want to do? Because I was kind of like, why can't I have a show of my own? But they presented the opportunity, which was the ladies' night situation with Coco Chanel and Angie Martinez, and we created that legacy.
So what other cast did you grow up with, like come up with in the game? Whether it be High 97 or Power, like who are some of your homies in the game?
I'm from the home of hip hop, and it's not too many people that I haven't at least met or know, honestly. I mean, even from the slain rappers to the present day young ones.
And as far as DJs.
Yeah. All the way back to Kool Herc. He's from the Bronx.
Nice.
He's one of the forefathers of hip hop. All the way to, that's a tough question. I have longevity, so I know a lot
of
people.
You've been through you've seen it all.
Yeah, so a lot, the good, the bad, and the ugly. Cool. Still here, so
what do you, how do you feel about this High 97 Power feud that's going on? We want to know.
Fuckery.
I honestly, because
do you think it's for the ratings?
I'm gonna answer her question how I feel about it. I honestly wish it wasn't happening. It was like, as it was manifesting, I was like, no. So I feel bad about it, because I know what it's like to be inside the machine and, you know what it's like. It's not for ratings. It's real. It's a situation that
I think it's real too, but you know, everybody got their little sayings, they're doing this for ratings.
No.
They're doing this for this, and you know.
No. I was 15 years in the machine, and a lot of things get handled before they even make it to the public. There's a whole lot of stuff that doesn't make it out the door, and that just was something. I think to categorize it, sum it up in one sentence, it was just a bad game of chicken. You know how it's like, what you gonna do? What you gonna do? And you thinking this person's not gonna do whatever.
Until something happened.
Until it got to the crunch time, and they was like, word? And they was like, word? And then they was like, well. So it was just a bad case of everybody pushing shit to the limit, and it just got ugly.
How do you feel about the Nicki Minaj performance? And her not performing, rather.
Non-performance. Now, if you follow me on Twitter, I said something to her.
What is your Twitter?
Follow me on Twitter at DJ Jazzy Joyce. And no dashes, no underscores, no slashes.
You the one and
no
only.
No spaces. Yeah, it's just
okay.
At DJ Jazzy Joyce.
So you addressed it on your Twitter.
I spoke to her. And the bottom line is, it's about the fans. You know, because there's so many things that people don't realize what we have to go through. Like, what y'all got to go through just to get here? All the bullshit you got to go through just to sit here. Imagine the stories I may have that I had to go through to get to play in front of people.
That's what I was going to say. You being, like, one of the women in the game, like, would you have gone out there if they would have said something to you like that?
That's my...
choice, in my opinion. I've done it a million times. There's been times where I had to decide, just like with the Africans, when I said, do I fight them, do I beat them up, or do I keep it moving? Right. There's a lot of times where I've been at clubs where I may not have gotten my money. The promoter left.
Right.
It's nothing I could do, but I'm here. I drove 2 or 3, 4, 5 hours, whatever it is.
Right. So she's just being emotional. She needs to just, she needs to suck it up.
She was more so, I think, being loyal.
I think it was all about ego.
On both parts.
Exactly, yeah.
Absolutely. Too much.
Ego, too much.
Male, my balls is bigger than yours now, in the room.
Yeah.
But she could have showed them all out if she would have went out there like, fuck all this shit. I'm still
going
to come out here.
It would have been the right thing to do, I think, for her to just keep it moving, go on with her job, which is to please her fans, not Flex or, you know, the
Rosenberg.
If we don't know what the discussion was,
no,
if I still was
not
in the building, I would have a little more insight on right. what the core of it is, because we don't know what the core right. of this
really
madness
is.
Yeah,
the
thing is that he's
been talking shit about her forever.
Yeah, they say it's
Rosenberg
beyond.
It's beyond
them or whatever.
She was like, you know, you ain't gonna play me when right. I was the reason why all these people are here. You know, it was an ego thing in a way.
I think that was a platform.
Yeah.
To kind of pick that as
the reason why.
Yeah, because we could go on Twitter. How many people say shit about y'all?
Right.
But it don't stop you. How many it don't. I tweeted that as well when this was all going down. I was like, imagine if I would have stopped.
Right.
Because someone said something about me. But it's I mean, we don't know. We don't know the true essence
but
of it.
But we understand what you're getting at. So,
yeah. it's always political.
What does Jazzy got going on now? That's right. What I want to know.
Right.
I'm working on my album. Well, not working. Finished my album. Trying to get funding so I could do the rest of my videos and get that out there. The purpose of my album is to display my producing and writing capabilities, because I've wanted to work with artists for years, but nobody wants to work with you kind of until you hot or whatever. So it's like just trying to do that. I know everybody's doing the clothing, the jewelry, the this and that. I have a t-shirt, starting with the t-shirt line, coming out under the Nick Every line. Nick Every is the parent company. NickEvery.com. The meaning behind Nick Every is there was a young man that his name was Nick, and he used to be everywhere. He was known for being everywhere, and he is no longer with us. So the pain of, I don't know the details of how he was, I didn't retain that information. Like, I don't know if he was killed or something. I think it was something tragic, and he's not with us. So it was homage from his boys and his family to start the line, Nick Every. So it's like, everywhere. This company actually started the flag t-shirts where you see them turn sideways, everybody, but nobody knew who
started
was
them.
It. Yeah, who was doing it. And then you got all these copycats and everything. So the name of my line is called Geeky Fresh. Geeky Fresh. It's for the intellectually fly, the geeks, the people that are behind these big machines that you see running the whole internet and the whole, all of those
like
brains.
Geek Squad.
Right, the brains, but usually they're the ones who got the money and got, usually when, with crews, like the DJs and everything, all of us, to run all of that stuff, the technology and everything, you have to be intelligent and geeky.
He's a geek.
Yeah, but
he makes like cancer. He does like cancer research and all types of AIDS research and shit. Like, what are you doing?
And he does the website stuff.
I work in pharmaceutical and I make research drug for HIV and cancer.
Yeah, he's wildin'.
Right, but he's a geek.
But you see, I tell him that every day.
You know what he does?
He has
the
suit and everything.
He works.
Like,
he wears a space suit.
He looks like an astronaut.
So he wears a space suit.
When my t-shirt comes out,
I need that.
He's the geeky fresh.
I need that.
So you're geeky fresh.
So that's, and I think
I need one. I know. I'm fresh. I'm smart.
What you just
I'm
said,
just
you
everything.
Said, what you
say?
You're
a Gemini?
Moschino?
Gemini.
I'm a Gemini too.
Yes. When was your birthday? You had your birthday?
No, 6 days. You didn't hear me say
it? Oh, but we don't care about all of that.
Nah.
My birthday was last week.
Happy belated.
Yeah, we don't care about
you. You remember when you did that? When I had my moment?
wait a minute.
But this is our guest though right here.
But wait a minute.
My other guest was a Libra.
And Gemini, like, they're like this. And I'm an Aquarius.
But I had two Virgos in my life.
No, I am not a Virgo girl.
No, Libra.
I'm a Libra.
What?
I mean, she a Libra. She
yeah,
does.
No, but
what's the problem? Let's no. talk about. Let's switch the exactly. subject. What about the Libras? Let's go.
That was
we broke your heart. We drove you crazy.
Tore my whole soul apart. Broke my nose.
No.
We are. Bex we are.
Best. Crazy, ever. Right? Crazy. Best sex ever in my entire life.
Nice.
Had my toes in
now
fish.
That's true.
Who was that? Libra?
Come on. Yes.
Sasha, yes. What you over there doing to your boyfriend?
But at the stand, she's tearing his ass up.
Tearing him up literally yes. and in the bed and all day.
All
Can
of that.
Can we talk about what you're wearing, Sasha? Where are you going after this?
Home. To be a good girl.
She's going to take this off, leave these
going
on.
Going balls deep.
Absolutely. You already know.
And have some type of eye infection.
Oh, what? No. What? From what? Skeet? In the eye? What?
That's what she's talking about.
I know, but that's why I
she's
just.
Freaking out.
But I told her, I was what? Like, listen, you got to be she careful. Be careful with the eyes.
Right.
Just because if that get in there, your eye will get little. It'll get real little. Like.
And swollen.
It will.
I've seen her eyes swollen before.
Because she was catching it.
Oh, shit.
To the face.
New York.
Bow. She got the, yo, her.
She could do that, though. Sasha could do anything, and she don't look crazy. Like, if I would have done this, I'm like, ew, Lonnie's a fucking disgusting whore. She does it. It's so cute. She's like, oh, my God.
Oh, my God. He skated in my eyes.
She's like, look at my eyes.
It's a little swollen.
She's like, she just got real. I'm like, what?
Because that shit probably hit the wall.
Really?
That shit hit the wall.
Bah.
Ouch.
No, but
that shit broke a shade off the wall.
Well, what are you? What's your
crazy.
Type? What's your type of? What do you look for in a female?
Unfortunately.
You not looking?
No. I was gonna say, unfortunately, I have the reputation of having lookers, meaning very beautiful women, and I don't know. I've been single for a little minute. By choice. Yeah.
So why is that? Somebody broke your heart. You need a couple years to recover.
No, because of my like. To be honest, when I got let go from Hot and everything, it
and
was
how
just
long ago
a
was
lot.
That?
A little over a year ago. It was just a lot. It was a lot. I was messed up. Yeah. I was like.
That's like a relationship right there. Almost.
It was just like, a long-term job situation, and I was messed up, so it was, I just have chose to just get me together, and I've been with somebody ever since I became sexually active. From the time I started, it was like, it was just like, somebody was always wanting to, you want to do it? I want to do it too, let's do it.
Right.
So now.
Nice.
No, but I'm saying it's a mature choice. I could not try.
You could get bitches.
Yeah, a little. So I mean,
you don't even gotta try.
When I cut off all my hair.
So what do? You walk up in the club like no.
No, I'm actually terribly shy when it comes to that. That's why when I used to hear young ladies would be like, oh, she tried to talk to me. No, I didn't.
Right.
Just like if I got, can I talk about that?
Yeah, we can talk.
I was still involved. I still was with my ex. And I hit Sasha, like she posted some pictures and whatever. And I was like, you look really beautiful. You know, you look beautiful.
You and Sasha got a whole history. Like,
what's going on?
I prepackaged it.
First, you put the pillow.
Rewind.
What time was it when you had hit her up?
Rewind.
You know, after
12
o'clock, it's booty call hours. I don't know.
What's going on?
Rewind the U-Street tape. I explained everything. I said I met her from the premiere, and then ever since then, we've been in contact, and this is the second time we've seen each other. I said everything from the T.O.P., so let me back it up. Stop. So I said to her on Twitter, like publicly, ain't no, because I'm not no sneaky, like, trying to whatever. And my ex obviously had timeline stalkers.
Uh-oh.
Went back. Let me tell you, she was on it, Twitter. I was like, I hit a DM. I was like, Sash, you're not going to believe what the fuck just happened. Da, 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 da. So it was just, it was hilarious. So I didn't give a fuck.
Sasha did, ruined your, you had to sleep on the couch that night?
Hell fucking no. Sasha, I was like, I told her. I said, first of all, you a bunch of dumb bitches.
Oh, sure.
Because it's like, really?
Really.
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 Like, there's, it's like that there's on Twitter. DM or whatever. Like, if I'm hollering or what, I'm not going to let y'all motherfuckers see I'm hollering at her. Fuck y'all.
You just said the picture was nice. That's all you were trying
that's
to say.
That's all? That's it.
You said
that's
phenomenal it. On her picture comment?
Nah, they say that was thanks to
her. Was it a? I want to know, did you give her the wink face? Because that really gets people angry.
Oh, the smiley face?
With the wink.
With the wink.
If that was it, that's why your girl got mad. I'm telling you.
I don't give up. I wasn't, it was just.
Look, I didn't do anything wrong. When she hit me up and she told me that, I was like, listen. I was like, no. I put laugh out loud. That's cool. I mean, I understand. You know, right. People.
It wasn't nothing. I was just, let her know, like, goddamn, let me tell you what just happened. It wasn't nothing.
Yeah, okay, it happens.
But you know what?
We all go through that little, women are weird. We get angry over the littlest things.
Totally.
You say something the wrong way, we feel like you have a little certain.
If you
trying to say a little something too much.
The vibe ain't right.
If you put an extra exclamation point right. You put a wink face, it's something. It's about to be something.
I think.
Because we know what's really good.
Exactly.
We're women. Hold on, we have up. That instinct. So okay. We ain't weird. We just know.
Yes.
And but I'm talking like this because.
I know because of the mic. No. But how do y'all feel about how the social network, see my interviewing skills swinging
I know
around.
You just swung it right around.
Go ahead, talk
and
that shit.
And I refrain from talk that because I'm conscious of that because I can do that so smoothly and so easily.
Like Yaris did that earlier when she had to tell us that she went to a fashion institute.
Right, I saw and you was like, hold up.
What happened?
Yeah, no, I was just good at that.
But
That's a good question.
No, but one question. You know, being that y'all are all attractive and all three of you, how do you feel about, you know, how social networking can bring strains to your personal relationship?
It fucking ruins it, okay?
Oh, it ruins it.
It ruins it.
I hate it.
Oh,
I'd be like,
God,
life was better. Listen, life was better without Twitter.
Hello.
That's the last real relationship I had was before Twitter.
Holla.
I'm not even gonna lie.
Holla. And the thing about it is, I'm believe it or not, I'm a monogamous spirit. I don't like to be all over the place. I'm scared of the cooties. I don't have time to. I don't have cake like that to be caught in a whole bunch of.
Because it's expensive.
Right, because I like to be good to
them. They want
to
go out every day.
The
beginning?
Feeding and seeing movies twice.
What
about?
Paying
toes.
What about social?
You can't have your bitches too close. You
got
abs
and shit.
Social networks, do's and don'ts.
Do's and don'ts.
You kind of like, you put your family in jeopardy. You could be at a spot location, and you put in your location where you're at, all type of shit, you know.
Don't talk to girls on Twitter.
I mean, it go both ways.
Like,
dude, okay.
Anybody. Don't talk to guys on Twitter.
Okay, that's
so what,
one.
Like, what's,
that's
not
one
worth
don't.
It.
Let me get a don't from y'all. From you, Sean.
What?
He said,
a do or don't.
Social network do's or don'ts.
Yeah.
So.
Oh, honestly, you got to be careful because people steal pictures. And they you still, don't know if you're talking to a man or a female.
We talking about relationships, though.
No,
but doing shit over Twitter.
Anything on Twitter? Oh, okay.
Doing stuff over Twitter, like, you get caught up. You see a picture
I heard
and you
a story
think it's
about
a girl,
that.
And it's not
really
the girl that you're speaking to.
Yeah.
So right there, cut this shit out. Don't
talk to people on Twitter. Like, if you know them, you know them.
Yeah,
don't talk to strangers. That's like talking to a stranger in public.
Hold on real quick, ladies. Let me just say something real quick. People that's watching right now, if you click refresh on your computers, we got two monitors running so you can see everything that's going on right now. You know what I'm saying? Click refresh on your computers and you can log in and watch everything that's going on. We got four cameras running right now. Go ahead, y'all. I'm sorry, ladies. Go ahead.
Do's and don'ts.
Yeah,
right. We're looking around.
Do's and don'ts. I feel like if you're in a relationship and you both have social network sites, do not, like, put your relationship out there in such a way that is so accessible to people to comment on and say certain things that really don't they have no business seeing. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, back in the day, we gotta get in touch with our roots. Like, this shit was not happening.
Right.
Random strangers were not commenting on your freaking relationship.
Right.
It was more like family and friends. Yeah. You know what I mean? Now this shit is getting out of hand, which is why there's no relationship going on nowadays.
Speaking of relationships and shit going crazy, let's talk about the whole thing.
Let's do
with
it.
Chris Brown, Drake, and RiRi. All right, now.
That good, good.
I really don't think it had anything to do with that.
You don't think
I
so?
I think that she's the it girl. Like, they're being territorial because they're men.
Hold on. But what could the else be? There's nothing else.
I think that was the start of it, but I think they're past that. And now I think it's about just, they all in the same industry. And when you in the same industry, it's like you're around the same fucking people all the time. So who else are you going to be competing with? And you know, when you're a celebrity, you sleeping with the same chicks. These girls is getting passed around. You know what I mean?
Can you believe this? I've never been with an industry chick, ever.
Thank God for that.
I'm more prone to be with somebody who's a corporate chick, or when I was younger, somebody that just worked at for like McDonald's, anything. Like, I wasn't tripping over that, because what I do is a job to me. And I love what I do. What I do for a living, but it wasn't like I thought I was better than anybody or whatever. Your job doesn't define your heart, your character, your soul, your upbringing, or
of
whatever.
Of course not.
But I think right now Rihanna is feeling it. She's like, she's just sitting back, like, what goes around comes around.
I don't know.
I think she might be upset, because why you wanna be even looked at as like that? You know what I mean? Like,
she's the one that did what she did. No, we don't know what she really did.
But accessible to the public.
She,
like,
you know, she was kind of out there though. From my own inside, Lou, you know, she was kind of out there. So, at this point, I think Rihanna, like, that's like fighting over the hottest sneaker. You know what I mean? That's like, you know what I mean? People are getting killed. It's men, because men have that pride. Men have that whole instinct, like, you know what I mean? So that was bound to happen. But it's sad that it ended. Thank God nobody was killed. But it's sad that it ended in that kind of violence, you know?
Yeah. If you realize, like, the history of things, countries have gone to war over pussy. But then disguise it as other things. Pussy is crazy. Like, it's nothing like...
Pussy made the world
any one of y'all, I know your men would probably kill somebody.
Yes, he would.
You know what I'm saying? What the fuck is up?
Fuck is that nigga?
Fuck is up?
Fuck that nigga.
Like, it come from what?
Oh, shit.
It's true. You know what I'm saying? Throw it. But you know what I'm saying? It's real serious.
Yeah.
It's real. I know, because I have lookers, and I always got tested. Like, I remember one time I was going, I was out, and, you know, I'm not the type. One of my past relationships was like, baby, no arguing with these niggas. It's my job to say I'm with you. You understand where she's going? It's her job to, like, kind of diffuse some of the combative energy that I would have to endure sometimes in protecting and deal. Not on some, I think I'm a nigga shit or anything like that, but she's like, it's your job as a, no, I'm spoken for, I'm okay, I'm, you know what I mean? But there's certain situations where it gets out of hand sometimes, I'm sure, where niggas is like, yo, so what?
Niggas don't give a fuck about the next nigga.
No, hell
you
no.
You don't. Listen, let me tell you something. Well, I mean, I don't mean you, but I mean, like, let me just say this.
They don't
Nobody
care.
Owe you anything in life, period. You know what I mean? And with that being said, everybody should just take that.
I just want to say that I like Sasha's little toes. They're so cute. I just can't stop staring.
You want to suck them?
Actually, I do. I want to suck them toes.
Wait, hold on.
I've never
something.
Seen toes this little and on an adult.
Happy feet.
I wanted to suck my man's toes, but his are too big.
I'm covering them.
Oh,
so
my God.
So yours are so cute.
But listen, before.
Hold up. I'm going to try to save you. Look, let's diffuse that. Okay. The toe action.
Yeah.
Yo, it's pull it. Just hold it. Plug it back in. See, you need to be geeky.
What are you taking wires?
She's doing too much.
Yeah, what you doing?
Oh, oh she's doing too much.
Yeah, you're doing too much.
Help us. Okay. Okay, she's back. She's back. All right, slightly geeky.
What are you doing to my girl?
So,
no, before I, like, you know, I never used to let anyone, you know,
your toes?
Yeah, by my feet. Aww. Like, I'm not a feet person.
You got pretty feet.
Thank
they're
you.
So cute and little. They're like little babies' toys.
You got them feet, like, when you hit it, it's like you want to just rub them while they up.
Oh,
right, hold them. And they're done up and stuff. That's that good shit.
Thank you. What happens to the lights in here? What's going on?
It just got a little hot in here.
It's all good. We still good.
We got the dim lights. No, so I'm talking about toes.
Can I just say this sidebar? You were excellent in the movie, and I hope you do some more movies. You were incredible. And that's
I like this the scene where she was with 50 in the tub.
You know what?
That was my favorite.
Hold
part.
Up. Everything.
I like that scene too, Lonnie.
I don't care.
But
I really care about nothing.
What I like about, you know, I like when you first see her, like, in the supermarket shit, in the aisles and everything. That's real life. That's that shit. Like, when you see a hot chick and she's with her man or whatever, and
he's like, she ain't gonna talk to me.
Right.
I work at a supermarket.
Right. And you like, you look like the way they depicted it and everything, and it was just, you played
thank
your
you.
Part
I mean,
well.
We, thank you.
My favorite part was still the sex scene, but anyway.
I mean,
yeah. I wanna know what song that was when y'all had the sex scene.
Everybody knows it. You better stop it.
There you go.
Oh, the shower scene. When y'all was in the shower, it was sexy. She was sexy. Besides the sex shit, she just was dope. And then her energy in real life is so strong. Like, when she came, you remember what I said to you? When I met you, I was like, I said, please don't kill me. Please don't kill me.
Oh, yeah. I'm like, and I would be like, I'm not going to do you like I did
I'm interviewing
Clara.
A couple.
Stop it. Oh. No, that's
clean up and aisle three.
No, we just
clean up and aisle three.
Nah, it's just from the first day that we met. Dope. It was so genuine. My spirit is what it is, but it's not driven by I want to fuck you. It's right. Like I just talk.
You
based
go off
on
a
what
vibe.
I feel
you go,
and what
you
I,
go off
you know,
a vibe.
Or it's either I'm gonna talk to you and I'm gonna really express what I feel, and or I'm not gonna talk to you at all. And some people can't take the truth, like that Gemini energy. We're very raw at times. So if you feel the love, I know she's not cool with everybody. She probably don't even go nowhere near anybody or whatever because she has to protect her energy and her being. All of you do. And
yo, that's some deep shit you're saying right now. You know that, right?
Yeah, I know.
The whole energy,
yeah, you
vibe.
Know, yeah.
Yeah.
I feel
so,
you, man.
But if you feel something, it's because she's not afraid to give it back to me because she knows. Because of how we met and just our
I
little
know.
Dialogue in that brief.
I was just joking.
I know. I didn't take it.
Okay.
Geminis are very, like, you know, we don't take nothing too seriously. Like, we know when a joke is a joke.
Hey,
we know when a joke isn't a joke.
I got a quick question.
Sure.
Real quick. Since y'all was talking about relationships and shit like that, okay. I want to know what y'all feel about, like, Shaq and Hoops. And before, remember a couple years ago, Game and all of them was clowning Hoops and shit, calling her all type of hoes and shit.
Right.
Now that she's with Shaq, nobody's saying nothing. And they're just having a great time. How y'all feel about this shit?
Are they still together?
Yeah, didn't they get married or something?
They're doing something, like a whole lot.
I don't know. I'm
sorry, I missed the whole thing. Sorry.
How did he say?
Your ass off the phone.
Sorry.
Shaq and Hoops.
How do we feel about Shaq and Hoops?
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I don't care about other people's relationships because people gonna do what they want to do, and if they're both happy, then I'm happy for them. Cause it's hard to find happiness, and it's
right.
hard to maintain a relationship in the entertainment business.
Uh-huh.
Definitely. So, big ups to them for making it.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of women and a lot of people judge women for their come up, in
uh-huh.
a sense. And I talk about, I've mentioned it lightly on Twitter and stuff. And I mean, like, you can't be mad at a bitch that got good pussy management. Like,
there you go.
Fuck that. So, I mean, let's keep it 100. Some bitches ain't fucking a motherfucker unless they got some cake. You can't be mad at that situation. You can't. And some bitches get mad because it's obvious when this bitch got more for her pussy than you did.
So
I don't
so
mean to
I like
put
my,
it so rawly.
What I'm thinking is like, what defines
real shit?
What defines a hoe? Is a hoe a girl that gets paid to have sex, or is a hoe somebody that just likes to have sex? Because there's women that like to have sex, and they have sex a lot, and they don't even need money. They just like to have sex. Is that a hoe, or is a hoe the one that gets money for it?
Hold on.
I'm confused.
I know it's a fine line. It's a gray line.
Real quick, though, before we get into that, you just said some real shit. There's girls that, you know, getting mad at the fact that that's what's working for the other chick, the next chick that is getting all of this, and she's sleeping with niggas.
Right.
That I do understand. But at the end of the day, it's whatever works for you and whatever you could sleep with at night.
Right.
Because at the end of the day, you got to deal with that.
Right.
So if you sitting there and you doing stuff for a certain cause, and fuck it, if that's what's working for her, that's what's working for her. But at the end of the day, she got to sleep with that shit.
Right, because can you look at yourself in the mirror?
That's
can
all
you,
that matters.
You know what I mean? Can you
do
deal with
what
yourself?
You do, and if you're gonna do what you do, be able to sleep at night. That's it.
I'm comfortable in my skin and in my sexuality.
Yeah.
I don't put it out there like but I'm comfortable within myself. I didn't know what I was feeling as a little girl was what it is. But my family loves me, my mother loves me, and that's what's important to me. And all else, I can deal with, you know, because like, I could go home to my family and they love me.
Yes.
And my friends. And most, a lot of, I have gay friends, straight friends, white, every nationality, every sexuality, every, whatever you could think of, I have friends, and they love Joyce. It's not about me DJing. It's not about my sexual preference. At the end of the day,
it's about your spirit, who you are as a person.
You know, absolutely.
It's like everybody has their own reality. Everybody lives life their way. There is no specific way to live life. That's something that the human race created themselves. They created labels. You know what I mean? There was a point
right,
in
to
time
categorize
in
and
life
control.
Where everyone was living